I think the highlight of this weekend for me was being recognized as a scholar and getting interviewed by various companies and just getting to network with different recruiters and then meeting them again in the career fair.
I'm in computer science, and so this is a STEM focused event, and I thought it would be a really good idea to be exposed to what there is to offer here.
I see that there's many companies that are here willing to open their doors and explain the opportunities that they have within their company.
The last few days have been life-changing in the professional aspect. I've been networking with a lot of recruiters and I've been networking with other students.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 2023 HENAAC Awards, presented by Great Minds in STEM. Please welcome tonight's MC, the star of Mayans and Party of Five, Ms. Emily Tosta.
Hi guys, good evening everyone. Buenas noches. Welcome to the 2023 HENAAC Awards, powered by Great Minds in STEM. I am super honored to be here with all of you guys tonight for the 35th anniversary edition of these prestigious awards as we honor world-class excellence in science, technology, engineering, and math. Okay, so this event marks the culmination of the 2023 Great Minds in STEM conference, which has actually seen over 3,000 students and professionals from industry, academia, government, and the military come together to recharge America with our youth. This is Great Minds in STEM's theme this year, Recharging America with Our Youth, and it captures the spirit of this organization and also this conference, but it is also a tribute to GMIS founder Rey Mellado, who passed away last year. Rey dedicated his life to empowering young people to pursue their dreams, first as a football coach and an educator, and then as a corporate executive, and finally, and most significantly, as the founder and leader of this organization for 34 years. And if you guys haven't figured it out yet, Recharging America with Our Youth is actually an acronym that spells out Rey. Rey and... So Rey and his wife, Carmela, they created these awards so that we could prove to America and also to ourselves that we, as a Latino community, can produce and are producing world-class engineers and scientists. So a round of applause for that. Latinos, Hispanics, Latinx, we have gone by many names over the years, but our story has been written in every corner of this country, every industry, every arena, and every segment of our society. Our story is the story of newly arrived immigrants who came with nothing but a dream. But it is also the story of families that have been here for generations. You know, many of our families fled war or poverty or instability to begin a new life and a new journey in the United States. But also many of us achieved success in our countries of origin and we migrated here to continue those journeys and to pursue even greater heights. So tonight, we are going to be meeting 22 remarkable individuals from every point on this spectrum. They come from Puerto Rico and Mexico and La República Dominicana, but also from Florida and California and New Mexico. So for some of these individuals, a career in STEM was actually the key to breaking the generational cycle of poverty in their families. And for others, success in STEM seems as almost if it was preordained. But what they all have in common is that they embody the spirit of these awards that honor world-class scientists, engineers, and technology professionals who just happen to be Hispanic. For 35 years, this award show has been a platform so that we could tell those meaningful and valuable stories to inspire the next generation of Latinos from New York to San Juan to Bogota to Seattle and anyone who dreams of a career in STEM. HENAAC Award winners are true role models for the Latino community and for America. So the class of 2023 will join this enduring legacy tonight, and they are going to prove that the story of Latinos in STEM still has many, many chapters to come.